Hey, it's Jose Chavez. I work with Savage here. I'm the head of product development there. And I want to talk to you guys about our new Ned program and what kind of makes it unique and what the thought process was behind making it. So with the Ned program, as you guys know, Ned fishing is an extremely effective and popular application in especially cold water, clear water, and very pressured fish. And we saw kind of an opportunity there in the market to introduce products that would be really well fine-tuned for that application.
Wonderful.
If you look at the products that exist in the world of Ned fishing now, most of them are very abstract and geometric. And in those, you know, high pressured fish and clear water situations, we've always found that realism and fine detail play an important part in improving performance in those applications. So what we did is we created a lineup of different Ned style baits that are very realistic and very detailed. It really has materialized. We've seen this happen. That skepticism that they have, whether they should bite it or not, whether they should eat it or not, it really, you see them lower their guard. You see their behavior change and feel a lot more comfortable with something that looks like the forage that they're actively feeding on. Our Ned program is made out of our Duratec plastic. It is an extremely soft, extremely durable plastic. What we've done here is we've added salt and scent to these baits. So the reason why we added salt is to control buoyancy. So when you're fishing a Ned rig, what you don't want, because our material is extremely buoyant, what you don't want is something to just like very quickly pop straight up. You want kind of a gradual ascend in the bait while it's underwater, and it makes it look more natural and really gets you more bites. So a quick run through on the lineup, starting with this little guy here. This is our Ned goby. He is 2¾ inches. It's a hollow tube inside with a solid head. So it gives you a lot of really nice material for your hook keeper to hold the bait. It has a fin that's split in the back that gives a really good exit point for the hook and gives you still that really natural presentation. So the idea is that the fin kind of hides the hook as it exits the bait. It has these little tentacles at the end that kind of move and oscillate independently in the water. So even really subtle movements are going to be seen and reflected. And even with its hollow body, it gives you a couple rigging options. You can, like a traditional tube, run a jig head in the body, or if you wanted to, you can run an external jig head. So depending on how you want this bait to fall, you can kind of fine tune the rigging to give you a few options. Our next bait is our Ned craw. So this is the smallest of all profiles. This is 2½ inches. And for those who are familiar with our 3D craws, we've basically taken that profile, which is extremely realistic, and downsized it significantly. We know that bass, they like smaller craws with small pinchers because it's not something they have to fight when they're eating. So if you're ever underwater and you're diving and you get the opportunity to feed bass crayfish, you'll see that, especially with the bigger ones, they kind of mouth it and wound it. And really they're trying to like kill the crayfish or get rid of the claws so they don't have to deal with them when they're trying to eat it. With this little guy and these tiny claws, it's really easy and appealing meal for them. So on our craw, we've left a nice little flat back portion here, and that gives you a couple different rigging options. So you can really rig this kind of standard with a Ned head. This is our Savage Gear Ned head, and it fits really nice and seamlessly and gives you a really clean connection between the two. And some of the people have fished our larger craws, which are 4D and 3D craws, and they work really well. Nico rigging. You could get something similar with a small presentation with a finesse Tokyo rig, and or even a drop shot that with a really small lead. Also, you can drop shot this and just tail hook it or nose hook it, depending on how you want to present this. But those presentations will help this get down on the bottom and really make it look like a crawfish scurrying along the bottom. All right, so the next one is our Ned Salamander, and this is an extremely ribbed salamander profile. So bass and salamander have an interesting dynamic. Salamander actively feed on their nests and their eggs. So a lot of times bass will kill salamanders on sight. You'll see that the salamander has very detailed small hands and their gills here behind the head. And with the extreme ribbing on this body, it has a really big presence on the water in that, you know, finesse compact presentation. Also, what you'll see here is we have a top and bottom hook slot. And these hook slots are really nice for rigging. A lot of times when you have a bait that's hyper ribbed like this and you're getting your hook through it, it doesn't come out clean. It tries to come out a lot of times between the ribs, in the middle of a rib. All the material in the head here really makes it easy for a couple jigging options. You could fish it like we have it here on our Ned head, and it gives you a really nice clean connection between the body and the head. Also, this is a great drop shot bait. It's got a really nice profile. It moves really well and bass respond to it. Our last one's the Ned minnow. So the Ned minnow is a 3-inch paddle tail. It has a T-tail at the end and it's still made out of our hyperelastic material. One of the things that is really nice about this is its face. We've optimized the face of this bait to work really well with either a Ned head or a round ball jig head. So it has this cupped face in the front and it fits these presentations extremely well. On the tail, we've added this little fin, and that serves two purposes. One, it looks a little bit more anatomically correct and real. So as we know, fish are looking at our lures a lot more than we think they are. And two, it gives it a really subtle yet natural kicking action. It's really fine-tuned for those, you know, pressured or finicky fish moments.
So all I've got here is just a finesse Tokyo rig with a little swim bait on there.
So we're starting to see some finesse bladed jigs hit the market, and this is really an exceptional pairing. So one of the nice things about it is it adds just the right amount of profile for those bladed jig presentations, and then the subtle action of the tail too. So it really adds the right amount of profile, flash, and vibration to complement those finesse bladed jig presentations well.